Good morning, this is Jacob Folger, sculptor, and today we're going to make a gargoyle. And we're going to start off with a ball of clay. And the way to make a ball, by the way, is just to roll it between your hands like this. And then when you, and so the first part is the torso of the body. So then you can roll it like this. And that will make it kind of going to a point like this. And I'm working on a board. Sometimes it's best just to have some kind of board to work on. And you can get the board wet and it will adhere better to the board. Just putting some water on here. That way it's not sliding all around on there. So I just press that down on the board like that and then it kind of sticks to it. And we're gonna make some assemblage of a head here to go on top like that. I'm working in self-hardening clay here. When it dries, it's very, very hard and very durable, but it's not waterproof. And you can paint and decorate it when you're done. I have a video on how to do a stone finish on clay and plaster, and you should take a look at that video because it'll show you how to finish it to make it look like stone. Okay, let's turn around. And I'm just blending this in. You'll see me blending a lot where I take my thumb or a finger or a tool like this, and I blend one part to another like that. So we've got, this is basically the head here and the torso of the body. Now we're going to do the rear legs. You can start off with a ball of clay, roll it between your hands. Self-hardening clay is available at most art stores and craft stores. Okay, and I'm just gonna put that leg on there and then bring it down. Actually, I need a little bit more clay for that. I'm rolling it off camera because it's a little bit easier to do it. There we go. I'm just going to put it on there and then bring it down. So he's going to be in a squatting position, which is a very common pose for gargoyles. But they're really fun. And get another one here. I'm rolling it off camera. But you roll it just to show you, you roll it like this, and that makes a long noodle, basically. And then you can put it on. It's not hard to construct these. So he's got really big legs. He's in a squatting position. There we go, just moving it, kind of readjusting it back there like that. And then to do his feet, you can roll a little ball and maybe a little bit bigger. And roll it at one end a little bit to form a foot, and then flatten it a little bit and press it into place. And I've got his toes going inward, or his foot going inward. And then roll another ball. And You see that sometimes they have one foot covering over the other foot like that. And then before I start, before I start his hands, I can just do this blending back here. Take a little tool here. There's a lot going on here. It's carving. It's piecing it together. Put a little bit of a track there, and we can round that off later. I'm going to start his face. I'm going to put a little bit of a snoot on him. So I'll roll a ball. So self-hardening clay, the main thing that I would say is when you go to buy it, make sure it's water-based first, because it'll be easy to work with and it'll harden. Oil-based clays don't generally harden. It's the problem with them. I'm going to poke a little hole there and a little hole there for his eyes. And I'm going to, let's see, I want to add a little bit of clay for right here for his cheekbones. But when you buy your clay, make sure it's soft. I mean, that's the thing that I find to be the most frustrating thing in the world is when you buy clay, you get it home and it's not soft. You know, clay has a shelf life. It'll dry out eventually. So if it sits on the shelf for a long time, and sometimes it does in these art stores, you don't want to get home with a thing of hard clay. So open it up. And it'll be wrapped in plastic, and just take your finger and press it in, and if it's soft like that, then you can buy it. If not, don't buy it, because you won't be able to knead it. Some people say, oh, I can knead it, but no, you won't. It's going to be so hard, you won't be able to do it. My hands are powerful strong. I have powerful strong hands from doing this type of work for so long. And working with clay and, you know, wood and what have you. And I can't. I have trouble kneading clay. Now we've got, you can see the basic shape of his head is coming around. So what we're going to do now is give him some eyeballs. And just put him in there. Just roll little balls of clay and just try to make them the same size. I'm just rolling two little balls of clay here. That's it, like that. And then we're going to make eyelids or eyebrows, the same thing in this case. I have them coming to a little bit of a point there. See a little bit of a point here. And do another one here. He looks pretty cool, actually. You know, when I sculpt, I don't usually have a humongous plan. I don't plan it out. I don't do drawings or anything like that. Sometimes I'll use an old gargoyle or something from something that I made before as a little bit of a, something to follow. But you can also look online for pictures and stuff like that. I want to put a couple nostrils in them like this. There we go. And if it comes up, if he needs a lower jaw or something like that later on, after I get him sculpted in a little bit, I'll probably do that. I want to add pupils. Yeah, I've got him going to the left a little bit, just to add a little bit of interest. There we go. And see, that's the basic idea of his face. Now I've got his front arms. I'm going to roll a ball and a noodle. Move him out of the way so you can see what I'm doing here. And roll another noodle for his other arm. And pull this leg down a little bit so I can get it in there. Pull this back up now. And now I've got him turned a little bit just to make him look a little bit more like there's a little, you know, more lifelike, I guess you would say. And now I'll start to sculpt in the parts that I added, the arms. So I'll start to starting to sculpt in the arms a little bit here. He needs elbows, so I'll take a little bit of clay here and add it to where his elbow would go. So you'll need paint brushes, you'll need sculpting tools, where you can get these at the art store or craft store. Let's put this. You'll need paint brushes for smoothing the clay when we're finished. Adding elbows here. You know, the nice thing about gargoyles, I used to do a lot of gargoyles. In fact, that's all I did for a couple years. And you can do whatever you want with them. I mean, they don't have to follow any particular rules. They're supposed to be formidable looking, but they can be cute looking too. A lot of people do cute gargoyles. I've done a good many cute gargoyles myself. I'm just doing some knees here. And I was really inspired. I mean, I got really fired up, and I was doing them a lot. And I started advertising for an open studio back in around 1994, for my gargoyles in the city paper in Washington, D.C. And the editor for the Washington Post art section saw my advertisements and said, "Do an article on this guy." And they did a big article on me. It was huge. It was, it covered, it was roughly two pages and had three sections. And after that, man, I was on the map as a gargoyle maker in that town, let me tell you what. So, I mean, I just was really inspired, and I started making them one after another, and my house was full of them. And I had an open studio in my house, and people would come in, and my dining room living room was the first room people would see when they came into the house, and and I would sit down, you know, sell my gargoyles there. I want to show you how to make fingers here. We basically have one hand we have to do in this particular case. I don't know how yours is going to look, but basically you roll a small noodle like this and just place it on here and try to do it loosely, because if you get it all tight and stuff, it just doesn't look right. My hands are difficult to do by any, you know, even me, after having done many, many hands over the years, I still have some difficulty doing them. The best thing to do is to bend them at the knuckles a little bit, where a knuckle would be, and keep them fairly loose. And my gargoyles have three fingers as a rule. So there you have it. And then you can add, you can take your knife and the pointy part of your sculpting tool, also available at art supply stores, craft stores, and that sort of thing, and just sculpt it in a little bit. That's a big hand there. That's all right. It's all right. There's no rules. And that's the one thing about gargoyles, you know. You can take this end of the tool here, and you can just press it here, and that makes a little fingernail. If you want fingernails. If you don't want fingernails, you don't have to put them in. And for the toes, we basically just have one foot here that we almost make toes for. Well, we might have to make more than one foot's toes, it looks like. But roll a little ball. And then you roll it at one end. See how I'm rolling at one end like that? One part is sticking out, this part is sticking out. It just makes a bat shape there. And then you just stick it on and blend it in. And then just roll at one end. And you have to play with it a little bit to get it to look right after. You can put this on a base, you know, you can take clay and just make a base for it. Sometimes that's better if you're gonna want to, you know, keep it around for a while and finish it and paint it up and that sort of thing. And then probably add a few toes down here, a couple toes down here for his other foot. So I've got one toe crossing, or the foot crossing the other foot, which is kind of cute. People tend to like that. So I do it when I make this kind of gargoyle. I do it a lot, actually. So now, he's well on his way, and if you want, what you can do is, you want to come around back, of course, and sculpt all that in. But when you want to smooth it out, do a few more things here. He could have ears, so roll a couple balls here. and stick them on there and blend it in. Like that. Do it on the back and on the back as well. And then maybe a couple horns. Oops, lost his finger. You just bump these things and they come apart, unfortunately. Till they dry. But for horns, you roll a couple balls and you just stick them on here and blend them in. You can blend them in with a tool if it's easier. It takes a little bit of practice, you know, to do this, but once you've done it a few times, it'll come to you more than likely. If you have any artistic sense about you, you'll probably be able to do it more than likely. Okay, so now what we can do is make the toenails for the gargoyle. You can just make little indentations with the tool. Now the thing to do is to smooth. And the way the smoothing is done is you take a glass of water. This has actually got several cups on it, just for keeping my desk somewhat orderly. And be careful around the eyes and the nose, because that can get messed up really easy with a lot of water. So what I recommend doing is dabbing off the water on either a cloth or the table or your base, like that. And then you just smooth it by brushing it. You don't have to do this. You know, I've done a lot of gargoyles where I didn't do it at all. And the reason why is because when it's finished, it looks like stone. I mean, it really looks like stone. In fact, I have a gargoyle right here. I'll let you see. This is a gargoyle with my stone finish on it. And when I sculpted this gargoyle, I didn't put any, I didn't smooth it. I left all the sculpting marks in, so it really looks like stone. So, there you go. But if you want to do that, you can do that. But if you want to smooth it, I show you how to do that here. And you basically just brush. It's like painting the gargoyle for as long as you want to smooth it out. And just watch out for those intricate detail areas like the eyes, because if you get it all wet, it's going to mess it up. And this is a cool gargoyle. I like this gargoyle. I think I'm going to maybe save this gargoyle and make a mold of it and add it to my sculpture list. He's pretty cool. So I like how his face turned out. Yeah. So that's basically how you make a gargoyle. And if you'd like, you can subscribe to my channel and visit my website at jacobfolger.com and my new website at jakecreates.com, which is all about my photography and has hundreds of images on there, all kinds of things, beautiful. And that's a new website, jakecreates.com. And thank you for watching.